Hello guys, myself Nikpal Sispadi from beginner2pro.in. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to create a time picker dialog. And one point, I will show you where you will get error when you will generate a signed APK. Okay? And most of the tutorial I have seen that they have done in that way, and most of the people have suffered while generating a signed APK. Okay, so I'll show you the point, and so let's begin with the project. Here I have already created a project named beginner2pro. Okay, so here I need to create a text view. On clicking that, a time picker dialog will arise. Okay, the time picker dialog will arise, and whenever user clicks or sets the time will be overwritten to this text view. Okay, text, let's say okay, center vertical to horizontal also 2, so the text size of 20 dp, assigning it a id time picker. Okay, so I'm ready with my XML file. I'll create the cast object tv time. Okay, time equals to text view time view by id r dot id dot time picker. Okay, so now I have created. Here I need to create a time dialog. Okay, means whenever user will click on this text view, okay, whenever user will click on this text view, a dialog will appear. So that's why I'm gonna create a time dialog. Okay, whenever user will click on the text view, this dialog will appear and will ask him to input the time. And from this main activity, I'm gonna pass the view. Okay, the pass the view of this to this time dialog, so that it will put the time into the text view. Okay, so I'm gonna extend it with dialog fragment. Okay, implements time picker dialog dot on time set listener. Okay, so the point is that if you will create a constructor of this and pass the view to this. Okay, because many of the people think that I'll create a constructor which will automatically get executed when the Java class will be called. Okay, it is the work of the constructor. But while generating a signed APK, it will ask you to empty the arguments passed to the constructor. So you cannot pass the view to the constructor and generate a signed APK, but you will be able to generate a unsigned APK. Okay, so that's why I'm gonna create a function. Okay, a function which will get the view. Sorry, I forgot to send a text view TV. Okay, so I'm gonna cast this one. Sorry, text view. Okay, the work is over. Now I'm gonna implement the methods. Okay, that is on create dialog is one method, and another one is on time set. Okay, so now it is error free. So I'm gonna now final calendar. Okay, you are gonna use this calendar java.util, not android.icu.util. okay, so click on this calendar. Calendar equals to calendar dot get instance. Okay, now I'm gonna get the hour of a day. Okay, sorry, hour calendar dot get calendar dot hour of day. Okay, now I'm gonna get the minute calendar dot get calendar dot minute. Okay, so now I got the hour and minute of the day. I'm gonna return this to the on time set. Okay, so that it will put this hour and minute to the text view which I have passed from the main activity. Okay, the text view is passed from the main activity, that is here. Okay, so return new time picker dialog get activity this comma hour comma minute comma false. Okay, so I have written here. I will change the variables. Okay, it is view and it is my hour of day which I'm getting from the on create dialog. Okay, now I will append this hour of day and minute to the string. Okay, it is needed to append, otherwise how will get a hour and minute same. Okay, the same time, because I'm using a single text view. So I will append this hour of day and minute to the string time, and I'm gonna set the text to time. Okay, now the time will be put to the text view which I have passed from the main activity. Now I'm gonna create an on sign on click listener so that whenever user will click on the text view, it will open the dialog. So on click listener. Okay, now I'm gonna create the object of time dialog. Okay, here is the time dialog. Dialog new time dialog. Okay, then time dialog dot get view. Okay, I pass the view to the time dialog and it will return me fragment transaction use version support v4. Okay, v4 library. Fragment transaction get fragment manager dot begin transaction. Okay, that is saying what required before found this. Okay, it is required. I have selected that. Yes, okay, although I have selected v4, but it cast it to only fragment transaction. Make sure that it must be v4, otherwise you will just click on here and change it to v4. It will automatically change. Now I'm gonna say time dialog dot show. Okay, pass that fragment transaction and time picker string. Okay, now my code is error free. Okay, if you want to experiment or try, then try creating a constructor and pass the view there. Then try to generate a signed APK for which is necessary to put it in Play Store. Try to generate a signed APK. Okay, you will not be able to generate. Only unsigned APK will be generated. Okay, so now I'm gonna connect to my device. Just wait. I'm gonna connect it. So connected my device. Let me turn on my emulator. Search for the device. My device. Oh, yeah, I got it. Okay, so at that time I will compile this project. In my next video tutorial, I will show you how to create a date picker dialog also. It will be same as like this, only this variables need to be changed. It will be a day and it will be date, month and year. Okay, nothing extra, only date, month and year, and pass it here and append it to a string and set it to the text. My device is a little bit slow, that's why it's not functioning. If you have any query, then do comment below please, and you will get the code in the beginner to pro.in. Okay, you will get the code there. Okay, so when I will click on this, look, a time dialog has come out. Okay, so it is getting the hour of day and the minute also, 17:20. It will be in 24 hours only. Here you need to change to AM, then okay, 5:20. Okay, so I hope you have enjoyed my video a lot. So if you have any query, then please comment below in beginner2pro.in, and please subscribe to our channel. Thank you guys, and have a nice day.